guys, welcome back to Math in a Hoodie. I put on my favorite hoodie so we can break down some basic math concepts today and become the strong math warriors that we all can be, right? Okay, today we're gonna practice adding double digits under 20. Okay, we're gonna start with a few single digits just to review, and then we're gonna move into double digits, okay? All right. So one thing I always talk about when we do math is when you're adding and subtracting, it's great to have a visual or something to look at that can represent the numbers, okay? That way it seems more real to you and it's easier to see the answer. So if you don't have something like toys or paper clips or pennies or erasers, you could use anything around your house. But if for some reason you don't have anything, you can always use your fingers and you can always draw little dots or circles or squares on your paper, can't you? Okay, so let's practice some of these. The first one is 6 plus 5, okay? Now, I have some colored pencils here. Let's use these, shall we? Okay, our first number is 6. So let's count out 6 first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, this is our first number right here. Now the second number is 5. So let's count out 5 and we're gonna keep them in our other hand. I'm gonna put these 6 right here in my pocket. Okay, let's count out 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, we're gonna put the extra away because we don't need them. So we have 5 and then we have 6. So now we have a visual of both of our numbers, don't we? Now we're gonna add them. We're gonna put them all together and mix them all up. And now how many do we have total? That's what we do when we add, right? We bring everything together and we add them up. Oops, I dropped one. We add them up to see how many we have total. Okay, so let's add up how many pencils we have. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So total there was 11 pencils. Okay, let's write that answer down. We have 11. Now guys, if we didn't have pencils or anything else to count, we could write little dots, huh? Let's practice that. The first number said 6. So let's go ahead and write 6 little dots next to it, okay? The second number is 5. Let's go ahead and write 5 little dots to it. Now, all we have to do is add our dots, and that's gonna give us our answer, okay? So let's count. We know this is 6, right? So let's add the 5 to it, okay? So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Do we get it right? We did. So you can double check by doing that, or you can just use this as your visual if you don't have anything that you could hold, okay? All right, let's do our second review. We have 3 plus 9, okay? Let's go ahead and do lines this time. So our first number is 3. Let's make 3 lines. And our next number is 9, okay? So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. There's all of our lines. Now, let's go ahead and add up our lines to find our answer. Ready? We know that this is 3, so let's add this to the 3. Ready? So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. There are 12 lines total, because we added them all together. We brought all the numbers together, right? Okay, good job. All right, now if you notice, when we added these numbers, these are called single digits. Single just means one. And that's because there's just one number only, right? So any number from 1 to 9, it's just a number all by itself, right? They're all just by themselves. But once you get to 10 and you go upward up to 100, They're called double digits. These are single digits, and these are double digits because there's two digits in each number, right? There's a 1 and a 0 in 10, which is two different numbers, okay? So when we look at this third problem I have on the board, the bottom number, the 3, is a single digit, but the top number is a double digit, isn't it? It has two different numbers. Now, when we add numbers together and one of them is a double digit, we have to put our numbers underneath each other in the right order or we won't get the right answer, okay? Right now, I have it under the 0. If I was to accidentally put it under the 1 and then add, I would get a totally different answer. So we have to line up our numbers correctly, okay? And we put all of our 1s in the 1s column and all of our 10s in the 10s column. Now, something that can also help you is when you have double digits, to draw a line right down the middle of them. See how I did that? I separated the two digits. And this helps us know which ones to add on this side and which ones to add on the other side. Okay, that always helps us. So let's start on the right side. Let's add these first two numbers. We have a 0 and a 3. What's 0 plus 3, guys? That's easy, isn't it? 0 plus 3 is 3, so we're gonna put that underneath, directly underneath, because this is the answer for this side. Okay, let's do the left side now. There's no number here, is there? When there's no number, you can always just draw on a 0 if that helps you remember. Or maybe you just automatically know that there's no number there, it just means 0. And 1 plus 0 is 1. Okay, and if we didn't have the 0 there, we would know it's just nothing. And 1 plus nothing is still 1. Okay, so let's go ahead and remove this little mark, this little divider there, and that shows us our answer. 13, 1 and 3, 13. So 10 plus 3 is 13. Okay, and if you want to check it, you could go ahead and write out the 10 lines and the 3 lines for here and add them all up to make sure your answer is correct. Okay? All right, let's go ahead and try 3 more different problems. Okay, guys, let's do 3 more problems to practice, okay? Sometimes it takes just a little bit of practice to learn a new math concept, and that's okay. Practice makes things permanent, okay? It also makes them easy to remember and helps you get the right answers when you take your tests. Okay, so I wrote 3 more math problems on here, and guess what? The top numbers of all these problems are double digits. Remember, they have two numbers in them. They're double digits. 18, 11, and 14. Okay, now underneath them, we're going to add just a single digit, and I've put it right underneath the ones, right? We have to line up our numbers correctly. To help us, let's go ahead and write our dividing line right down the middle of our double digits, help us make sure we're adding the right numbers each time, okay? Because if we mix them up, we'll get the wrong answer. We don't want to do that, do we? Okay, let's start with number 1. Okay, so we're going to do one side first and then the other side. So the two numbers we have on this side are 8 and 1, okay? So let's write the answer right underneath those. What's 8 plus 1? Super hard, huh? It's 9. Good job. Now, we don't have any number here, so we can either write in our 0 if we want, or we can leave it blank, and 1 plus 0 is 1. Okay, so there's our answer, 19. See that? Good job. See, once you've divided it, you can do it really fast, right? Because it's usually really easy addition once you divide it up. Okay, let's do number 2. So on our right side, we're going to do this one all by itself. We have a 1 and a 4. What's 1 plus 4? Good job, it's 5. Again, there's nothing here. This is the addition sign. I'll scoot it over just a little. There's nothing here, so we're going to add 1 plus nothing, and that's going to give us 1. Good job. So the answer to this one is 15. Now remember, if we wanted to check our math, we could write dots or squares or circles for each of the numbers. So here's 4. And there's the 11, and we could now count all of the lines, and it would tell us our answer, and we could check it, right? Okay. All right, last one, guys. Number 3 is 14 plus 5. We've divided it in half so we know which numbers go with which. What is 4 plus 5? 4 plus 5 is 9, and we put that directly under the numbers that we added, right? We have to keep everything on its right side so we get the right numbers. Okay, again, there's nothing under the 1, so 1 plus nothing is 1. Oh, look. These both have the same answer, 19 and 19. That's cool, huh? All right, see how we did that? So to make sure you get the right answer, draw your middle line, divide them up, line the numbers, and then just go straight down. And if you want to check, you can make little dots or circles, whatever you want, of each of the numbers off to the side, and then add them together, okay? So this would be 14 and 5. I could add all those dots, and that would still give me my answer. It's just a way to check to make sure we did it right, okay? Good job, you guys. That was great practice. Let's do 2 more. Okay, guys, I'm so proud of you. You're doing so great. Let's go ahead and do these last 2 problems, okay? Well, I have 12 plus 6 and 17 plus 3. Again, both the top numbers are double digits because there's 2 numbers in each of them, right? This has a 1 and a 2, 2 different numbers, and a 1 and a 7, 2 different numbers. Now below we have our single digit, 6 and 3. We're going to add those together, okay? Now remember, when we have double digits, we're going to write our line, whoop, divide them up. And that way we're not going to get mixed up with what number we add to what number. Okay, let's start on our right side first. We have a 2 and a 6. What's 6 plus 2? It's 8. Good job. And we have 1 plus 0. Super easy. That is 1. So our answer is 18, huh? Okay, let's come over here. Our right side is the number 7 plus 3. What does that come out to be? That comes out to be 10, okay? So we're going to put the 0 down here, and we're going to carry the 1 up there because we can't put 10, because if we were to put 10 and then bring our 1 down, that would show us that the answer is 110, and that's not true, is it? No, we can't do that. So when we have, when our answer turns into a double digit, we put the first or the 1's number under there, and we carry the other one. So with 10, we put the 0 here, and we carried the 1. Now we add all the numbers in this column. 1 plus 1 is 2, okay? All right, and you could also use your fingers, 17, 18, 19, 20. That was 3 and that came up to 20. Or you could write the lines out, couldn't you? Okay, good job, you guys. That last one was a little tricky because that's the next level of adding double digits. So I wanted to just throw that in there for you. But you guys did a great job. I'm so proud of you. Keep practicing adding double digits, and we'll see you next time on Math in a Hoodie.